Curiosity.
Yeah.
You got to be curious if you ever want to be great.
Yeah, absolutely.
Everybody we talk about, if you're going to be great at something, you better be curious.
Yeah. Well, I think it's pretty profound.
Greatness is the willingness to die. Mm-hmm. Mm. That's greatness. Mm. Like you see these guys, forget about suicide guys. Forget about the guy. Just people that are decent people just decide to kill themselves. Mm. You know? What makes a person does that? And they do it young age, 15, 16. And it's just, how do you say it? Is 15, 20 years old, you experience enough life to realize, hey, I don't want to be here no more. Mm. It's something about yourself that you just hate so bad. Mm. Any kind of killing is a form of self-hate. You know? If I'm killing somebody, it's just everything I say about it. If I call him a dirty motherfucker, that's because I'm a dirty motherfucker. Mm-hmm. If he's a bitch-ass nigga, it's because I'm a bitch-ass nigga. We reflect of one another. That's why people are inspired by it. That's how come we get inspired, you know? Because we're a reflection of one another.
Yes.
And they allow us to know what we can be. Mm-hmm. Even though we're in bad situations, this is what we can be. Mm-hmm. My whole life is about robbing. Listen, I come from that world of robbing. My mother slept with me. My father's a pimp. And this is my world. Can you imagine? Look at me. I'm a fucking savage. I see my mother sleep with men, fuck men. It's just who I am. Sex and me, that's probably why I got in trouble with sex, because sex and me is like, whoa, it's like breathing. And I know it should be like, but it's just like breathing, like perversity and sex and that stuff, and me in a room and a bunch of women, like, sex, and that's natural to me, because that's who my mother and father is. Mm-hmm. Mm. You know?
Yeah.
Even to this day right now, I have to check myself. Always check myself.
Yeah.
You know, my wife is my consciousness.
Yeah.
Why is my masculinity in a woman? My mother fucked me up. That's why my masculinity is in a woman. See, why am I so overbearing to my wife? My wife must say, this nigga is overbearing. As long as you love me, but the nigga is too much. I know she must think that, you know, because I'm afraid of losing her. And I think to myself, when I'm so aggressive and I love her and I give her so much love, that's chasing her away. Mm. But why can't I control it? Why can't I just stop and be in a Mac and with all the other people? Why can't I do that with her the way I do with everyone else, the other women? Like, they're nothing. Because my masculinity is in her. Because my mother fucked me up in some kind of way. Mm. Seeing her fuck men and seeing men fuck her and how she responds to all that stuff. And I want to make people respond the way my mother responds. When I'm fucking, when I'm making love, or whatever we call it. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm looking for those sounds that my mother made that I heard her sing. Mm-hmm. Does that make sense?
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
It's like, how do you unsee something? Mm. Can you?
No, you can't. No, brother.
You can't.
Listen. I'm in love with that picture. Mm. Of people fucking my mother. I'm in love with that picture, that ecstasy, that passion. I'm in love with that. I keep rolling those pictures in my head. I'm in love with the picture. I'm addicted to that.
Mm. Yeah. Different. Mm. And how do you, well, at least for me, like I said, like going through hard times, and how do you change the story? How do you say, okay, I'm gonna change the story. Can't change what happened, but I'm gonna change the narrative on how it spoke to me, and I'm gonna make it speak to me this way now. Instead of that negative way, I'm gonna make it be a positive way, and be a light going forward.
Then when you do that, that sounds great.
Sounds, yeah.
That sounds good, but then and then we're dealing with what you're dealing with now. Mm. You don't want these people to know that I do this. Like me, I have no secrets of anything. Everybody, I'm so transparent. That's why I've lost so much, you know? So this is my only freedom, being able to be on this mic. And I don't like this because this makes people think that I'm somebody special. And I don't want nobody to think I'm somebody because I don't have a good opinion of myself, you know? But for my ego, this is great. You know, my ego is something I'm trying to get away from. But when I get away from that ego, when I distinguish myself, I'm such a coward. I need it back because I'm like, oh, I hate myself. When my ego goes away, I'm a bitch. I'm like, oh, I don't know what I am. Everything I'm afraid of, I don't know. Gimp, come back. I don't know. How do you get rid of that guy?
Mm-hmm. You talk about him.
Yeah. We need him. He's here for a reason. Yeah. Why is he here? And we keep getting away. No, my ego tells me
sometimes. You acknowledge
it. It tells me sometimes, listen, I tell you, you're going to do this shit? Look, this is where I got you. I got you here with Rob. I got you here with Tyson fucking Ranch. I got this. This is what I got for you, Mike. But listen, only thing I want you to do to pay me back, all right? I just need you to, I need you to fuck her. And then we're even. That's what my ego tells me. I need you to fuck her. You fuck her, and then we're even, Mike. Mm-hmm. But I don't want to fuck nobody but my wife. Yeah. But that's what my ego say. I gave you all this. Just do me a favor, Mike. Fuck her.
Yeah. Yeah.
Fuck the ego, man.
Huh?
Fuck the ego.
Hey, listen, that's what everyone says. You're saying in that, but it has you, it has all of us.
Oh, I know.
We can't live without it.
Well, it comes, and it's going to come. I was listening to something last night on, I think it was on Alan Watts. I don't know if you ever heard of him.
Yeah, love Watts, Alan.
Beautiful. Yeah, and he was talking about a Buddhist story or whatever, and a great Buddhist was saying that there is no such thing as permanence. Mm. That you will not be a permanently blissful or happy.
Yeah.
Just like you won't be permanently sad or ego-driven. That it's going to come, but it's about letting it come and don't run from it.
Yeah.
Talk about don't be afraid of it. Take it.
Yeah.
And then go through the other side of that. Because that's where the life is.
This is going to be, why do we listen to these people? The fuck are these people? They don't even look like us. Why do we listen to them? Mm-hmm. He's from another fucking way of living, life, strength. You know, he don't look like us, think like us, or nothing like us. Why do we listen to them? Mm-hmm. Why?
Maybe because I'm thinking that it's an energy that you can feel wherever you're at that point. If you're ready for that, it'll hit you. Just like if you see a pimp on the corner and that speaks to you and you say to yourself, I want to be like that. That's where you're at that time, energetically. Or you see a pimp on the corner and you say, I'm not there. I'm somewhere else. I'm not saying it's better or it's worse, but I'm at a different energy, vibration, and frequency. Your frequency is your currency.
I don't
that's where you're at. I don't know.
From the world, I think we don't like what we're doing. That's why we listen to people. Mm-hmm. You know, because that's we in some way we take what they say and we want the world to believe that we said it. Mm-hmm. You know, that's the perspective of ourselves. That's the what I say we do. What's that word I used again?
Self-reflection
illusion?
Examining yourself. Yeah.
Inventory.
When you do your inventory, you can't lie. That's why when I do my inventory, I can't lie to myself.
Yeah.
You know, and I just say, fuck. Yeah. You know.
Yeah.
These are the things that I have to deal with.
Yeah.
It's good that you're asking these, because most people are too afraid to ask questions about
themselves. Oh, well, here's the thing, though, pain. Mike, about the ego. And Alan Watts talks about this. Is that the ego is an illusion that you've created. There's no spot in your brain that generates this shit. The ego is this fucking creation.
So why did we create him? Why did we create
him? To protect yourself.
Yes.
To keep yourself safe.
Yes.
To aspire, because you can't imagine that you can be the person that everyone loves and holds up in all of your successes.
You know, my ego tells me. My ego knows that I'm a great follower of Alexander the Great. My ego said, fuck that nigga. What it took him 20 years to do, you do in one fight. What it took him 20 years to do for people to know who he is, I do it in one night. Well, but still, I don't want to think of myself as something great. Something has to be great in order for me to. I can't look at me as just me. I just, it's just.